listening to an audio article by the Common Constitutionalist. Today's article is entitled The Muslim Brotherhood Five-Step Program to Domination. Watching and listening to our two Muslim Congresswomen, Ilhan, Omar, and Rashida, Tlaib, I can't help but recall the Muslim Brotherhood's five-step program to dominate the United States. Yes, the Muslim Brotherhood, the originator of modern-day terrorism, from which all modern Islamic terror was born, has a five-step program or strategic plan to take over Western nations, including the United States, and subjugate all its citizens for all to submit to Sharia law. Many may think this sounds far-fetched, but just listen and then decide for yourself. And don't blame the messenger. I didn't concoct this plan. The plan is called Civilization Jihad. This five-step or phase plan was crafted by Mohammed Akram, a senior Hamas leader in the United States and board member of the Muslim Brotherhood of North America, and approved by its Shura Council in 1987. Their mission statement is as follows. Quote, "The process of settlement is civilization jihadist process with all the word means. The Ikhwan must understand that their work in America is a kind of grand jihad in eliminating and destroying the Western civilization from within and sabotaging its miserable house by their hands and the hands of believers so that it is eliminated and God's religion is made victorious over all other religions." Unquote. Phase 1 calls for discretion as members and operatives arrived in America and other Western nations. They are to keep a low profile, go about their business as shop owners, students, and professionals. They are to be seen as model citizens, gaining respect within their vocations and communities. Years or even decades may pass between stages. If nothing else, Islamists are patient. Phase 2 requires Muslims to begin to come out of the shadows. This can only be achieved when there is sufficient population. They are then to begin gently pushing for recognition of Sharia law, but only within their communities and sphere of influence, all the while publicly siding with the West against radical Islam. They insist that Islam is a religion of peace while co-opting Western progressive leaders in this insistence. They assure these leaders that Sharia will never be applied outside their own communities. Phase 3 is one of penetration and escalation. This, in my opinion, is where we are at presently. When there are enough Muslims in any given city, in any given region, they begin to penetrate Western society beyond their communities. For example, Dearborn and Minneapolis. Perhaps even enough to get a couple of congresswomen elected, like, say, Ilhan Omar and Rashida Tlaib. They build mosques like crazy, many more than are needed, funded by foreign entities. In 1994, there were 962 mosques in the United States. Today, a mere 25 years later, there are around 2,200. They roll out more and more front groups and organizations to make it appear that they have more clout and influence than they actually do. There is no better example than the Brotherhood front group CARE, which has a staff of about 70 and little more than 300 volunteers. Yet they are treated with more respect and frankly feared more than the NRA with its 4.5 million members. By sheer coincidence, both congresswomen have met with CARE, a Muslim Brotherhood front group, on more than one occasion, and are publicly supported by the Muslim American Society, which was founded by members of the Brotherhood. The job of these front groups is to pressure politicians and academia for Islamic studies in prayer areas, claiming victimization and demanding accommodations. They are to file lawsuits and cry Islamophobia at every turn, thus wearing down their Western hosts. Then it's on to Phase 4, where Muslims, now a rather significant minority population in the host country, become more belligerent and insistent that Sharia law be woven into the host's legal and political system. Violence from supposed independents and disparate radical groups may also be a part of Phase 4. Phase 5 is their envisioned final step, as Muslims now have become the majority, or at least the ruling minority. All the veils have been pulled back, and there is no more pretense of getting along as they terminate any non-Islamic influence. Sharia law is then imposed nationwide. Don't think it could happen here. You must always remember that these are a patient people, and this is a 100-year plan. We are less than 30 years in, and they are already at phase 3. Thank you for listening.